So I am Bhushan Shah, and I am currently working on Plasma Mobile from like last year. In previous year, Sebastian and Bao represented the Plasma Mobile to KD community. And after that, it's been a year. So, well, this presentation is about the current status of the Plasma Mobile project and what we need to achieve in next milestones. So, first I'm going to give a small introduction about Plasma Mobile and the developments that have happened in year, and how can you contribute to this project. So first thing is Plasma Mobile. If you don't know, it's a free, user-friendly, privacy-enabling, and customizable platform for mobile device. Initial images that were presented at previous Akademy were based on Ubuntu Touch and used to work on LG Nexus 5. Plasma Mobile is a successor of Plasma Active project. After the Akademy, we decided the vision for Plasma Mobile. So it's Plasma Mobile aims to become a complete software system for mobile devices. It is designed to give privacy aware users back their full control over their information and communication. Plasma Mobile takes a pragmatic approach and it's inclusive to third-party software, allowing the user to choose which application and services to use. It provides a seamless experience across multiple devices. Plasma Mobile implements open standards and it is developed in transparent process that is open for community to participate in. So for Plasma Mobile, we are mostly reusing 75% reusing the same stack that is used by Plasma Desktop. So if you are contributing to Plasma Desktop, then you are as well contributing to Plasma Mobile. Another interesting development that happened was Kirigami. Kirigami is a successor of Plasma Mobile components. Plasma Mobile components were mainly used in Plasma Active, and they were now redesigned for Plasma Mobile and as well for another mobile systems. They are not just components, but on wiki page there are user interface guidelines which you can follow and make your application. There are user interface guidelines which your application should follow. The first non-KD application which started using Kirigami was the Subsurface Mobile. They started using Kirigami for their, I guess, first mobile version, and there are also iOS version work in progress, if I remember correctly. There are multiple Plasma Mobile applications, including Peruse, Spacebar, and also recently the in-depth Plasma Desktop Look and Feel Explorer started using Kirigami. One of the other development I worked on was it was a stack, device stack based on Cyanogen mode. So in initial images, we started using Ubuntu Touch, but after a while, it became like hard to maintain. Some of the reason were compatibility issues. For example, Ubuntu Touch uses Qt 5.5, Ubuntu does used Qt 5.5 while our Plasma stack was using Qt 5.6. So there was incompatibility issues. Also about libhybris. So in libhybris, they have forked version which have compatibility code, and we wanted to use newer libhybris which have some better features for Wayland. But apparently the newer version and the Ubuntu's patches couldn't apply with each other, and they were not compatible at all. And we wanted to use newer libhybris, and also the current Ubuntu Touch version is based on Vivid. 15.04, while we wanted to use Xenial, that's 16.04. That the main reason to use newer stack was we didn't really had much resources to maintain separate repository for Vivid and Xenial. We wanted to just reuse the packaging that is provided by KDE Neon. And so I came up with this, the Plasma team came up with this simplified stack in which the mobile device boots the CyanogenMod mode or Android open source project-based system. And we start Plasma mobile system inside the Alexi container. That's the complete reverse of the Ubuntu Touch stack. In Ubuntu Touch, they puts a normal Linux system and puts the Android part in the Alexi container. Some of the advantages this newer stack gave us was it was easier to run Plasma mobile because after all the Plasma mobile shell was in contained in the Alexi container, so you can theoretically create a Alexi container which could be deployed on same CyanogenMod system. And as well, we now have more control over the how we want to start a our start Plasma mobile session on mobile device. And this Plasma mobile project also brought multiple improvements in Queen and Wayland. So first thing was Queen have HW Composer backend. So there are multiple improvements in. The first thing is dynamic power management support in that backend. So, on the Android devices, mainly you need to turn set brightness color to black to turn it off. So Queen HW Composer backend gained support for that, and as well on mobile we needed lock screen. So I implemented the lock screen support in Queen Wayland, and which also and that development also due to that development Plasma Desktop also benefited from that. In Queen Wayland there are lots of improvements related to touchscreen, including different effects for touchscreen, and there is also Qt Virtual Keyboard support. Qt released this Qt Virtual Keyboard with 5.6, and they made in open source in 5.7. So currently Queen supports Qt Virtual Keyboard on desktop and as well mobile. There are multiple plans for future, like enabling to run Plasma Mobile on multiple devices, more proper integration with Plasma Desktop, convergence, and more third-party applications. The first point is enabling more devices. So this is the point where our Plasma team fell short, because we don't have access to as much devices as other contributors would have. So this requires a community interaction to actually port Plasma Mobile to your device and make it run on your device. Integration with Plasma Desktop, that is the currently KDE, we have KDE Connect. There are multiple possibilities where we can integrate Plasma Mobile with Plasma Desktop. And then there is a convergence. That's also in one of the to-do list for Queen Wayland. It's like automatic rotation and like when you plug in your phone with a larger display, it shows Plasma Desktop probably. And we also need more third-party applications and in Plasma Mobile, because currently we are quite lacking in the overall applications on Plasma Mobile. So if you want to contribute to Plasma Mobile, these were the multiple options, like run a Plasma on your Plasma or Plasma Mobile on your mobile devices, more applications. And if you want to know more about this, I'm also taking a breakout session of Plasma Mobile in Plasma Bof. I guess that's it. Do you have any questions?
How is the status of running Android apps under Plasma Mobile, or is it even planned?
It's a little bit different than Plasma Mobile project, because if you manage to run Android application on Linux stack, then you can easily manage it to run it on Plasma Mobile, because after all, Plasma Mobile is just normal general Linux stack.
So basically, you can run it because you're now based on CyanogenMod.
No. The thing is, we strip out the actual Android stuffs like their libraries. Java libraries and those parts we strip off. That is completely minimal CM version, which just boots and runs binary blobs required for the hardware support, and then it passes to the LXC container, which Queen takes over and shows the.
Not more a question, just a precisation on the question before. If you're interested to try to have Android application on Linux, try another project that is called Shashlik.
Yeah.
That's what it does, basically. And that there is not really a difference whatever the application is running on a normal Linux desktop or on a Plasma Mobile on ARM.
Any more questions? Okay.
Yeah, hi. My name is Tuukka. So have you mentioned Qt Virtual Keyboard. Have you used the handwriting recognition features of it? And if so, how did you find the performance sufficient? Or
currently, Queen doesn't support, I guess, touch. That's Martin.
So when I tried it, I was not able to compile it on Linux at all. It looked like a Windows-only feature. So that makes it impossible. Then the packages to build it are not available in the standard Linux distribution.
It's more like there are multiple dependencies which are probably not documented, or we need to figure it out. And
Yeah, it's mainly for the embedded Linux, and that's why I was interested, because there's two backends that are used, that can be used there. One is coming from Nuance, a commercial one, and then there's this the open source one.
Yeah.
And the Nuance one is faster to recognize. You can write like consecutive, and then the open source one is much harder for the processor. So that's why I was interested, that if you have tried the open source one, that did you sort of find it acceptable? Because often in the embedded devices, especially if there's not so much processing power, it requires to have the Nuance backend for like really smoothly working. But on desktop, the open source one also crunches fast enough. But if you haven't yet, but let's sort it out. I'm sure somebody can help. It's intended to work with embedded Linux, so it should work.
Anyone else? Yeah.
So about 1 year ago at last Academy, we also had the first announcement of the Plasma Mobile project, right?
Yeah.
And we also had a demo that was quite surprising, I would even say, because a lot was already working, like doing real phone calls and also some basic app management and so on. The question now is, what's the current state? Are we still where we were 1 year ago, or are we maybe even further down the road and we can do more? Or did the stack underneath change so much? And given the rather limited resources, as I understand, we didn't make much progress. Or what's the current take on that?
So the current thing is we had too much problems with the underlying stack, that we had to mostly rework some parts of it, so the actual visible development didn't really happen. The first thing was like the demo that you saw at previous Academy was based on older Ubuntu versions, and then we migrated to newer LTS Ubuntu LTS release, and then I had to rework on Cyanogen mode stack. So overall, the actual Plasma Mobile project didn't see that much development compared to the whole backend part.
I tried Plasma Mobile last year in Randar.
Okay.
And it took like 10 seconds to crash every time. Yeah. Did the stability improve since then?
Yes. The thing is, since it is using HW Composer backend, and Queen also have DRM backend, so most of the Wayland issues are fixed in DRM backend, but some issues go through those HW Composer backend. So stability has improved. And as well, one thing is we need to more stabilize the Plasma on Wayland, so Plasma on mobile will automatically improve itself.
Thanks.
The talk last year ended with an estimation that Plasma Mobile would be 1 year from being able to be productly used.
Yes, right.
What's your current estimation as to that?
That's the tough question. So actually, as I said,
A lot of that depends on more people pitching in. It's never going to happen if people stand around it and watch it and wait for it. It's our thing. That was clearly communicated as well. If people don't pitch in, we could make it happen within 1 year, but it's a lot of people have been standing at the sidelines and looking at it, and some people have been testing it. We had pretty good feedback. We worked a lot on the underlying stack to make the base system a lot better, but there wasn't a single KDE developer who said, hey, how can I get my application running on Plasma Mobile? And I think that's really the core problem. If we want to make it happen, it's not going to happen by itself.
So again, from speaking from Blue Systems perspective, it's a good thing that the Plasma Desktop and Plasma Mobile share most of the underlying code. So the benefit is with regards to Wayland, we have a good testing platform, and since both are using Wayland, the upcoming Plasma Desktop, we see issues early on, and so for the last year, mainly only Bhushan worked on it and reworked most of the base to make it much more independent from Ubuntu Touch, much more independent from Ubuntu itself, and using PPAs. So we now have our own repositories. We could port it easier to Debian or SUSE or any other platform. And the main thing, it's still in a prototype state. But if there would be a trend that goes to convergence or having a phone as a base that you connect to a larger screen, I think it's pretty good that we in KDE have a system that if we put one or two more developers in for a certain time, it could easily catch up with really professional systems like Canonical or Android even. So this is more of an ongoing thing that we are very focused from Blue Systems on making Plasma Desktop stable, prepare a Plasma Desktop on Wayland. And so having Plasma Mobile is basically some fallout that we get greatest. Okay.
Just another little thing to add. For who was already here for the talk from David, one of the takeaways was Android Desktop is coming, and that could be true. And one thing that could happen as a consequence that many. That a lot of desktop hardware, even real laptops, I'm not only talking about tablets or phones, the only way to run a complete Linux system on those laptops could be a stack like Plasma Mobile, so on top of CyanogenMod, on top of maybe using libraries, and these could be a not really happy scenario, but I like to see a project like Plasma Mobile as an insurance against this possibility.
And also one other thing is we need to wait till Plasma Desktop runs Wayland completely, and then we should switch. Then only we should consider Plasma Mobile as a stable, because ultimately Plasma Mobile is using Wayland. So if our Wayland stack is not completely stable, then Plasma Mobile is never going to be as much as stable.
Question here. So by moving out from the Ubuntu Touch base to the CyanogenMod one, we actually lose the possibility to run Ubuntu Touch applications. There's the web browser and stuff that's not so bad. So reusing them is cool.
So the thing is, Ubuntu Touch applications can be run on Plasma Mobile, but can be run on its current stack. But the problem is Ubuntu Touch applications. Problem is, as I said, the compatibility. They are compiled with either Qt 5.5 and 5.6, and we want to run it in 5.7. So that's the mismatch. And that doesn't work out. Otherwise, we can run any Linux application, be it Ubuntu Touch application or whatever, on Plasma Mobile. In fact, I had every Ubuntu Touch application almost working 2 weeks back, and then Ubuntu UI toolkit stopped working with Qt 5.7, and I couldn't manage to find how to build it. So that's the point where I had to remove Ubuntu Touch application for some time.
Okay. Any more questions? No?
Yeah, just a remark related to the browser, that there's also the Qt Web Engine-based research browser that you could try that one. Yeah. It's maybe we could even get it to work. Yeah.
Please make it not crash on Valent. Thanks.
Yeah, I think it's Kai who may be able to deliver that. But yes, it's you are not the only one who doesn't want it to crash on Valent. Yes.
Yeah.
So I actually wrote a Web
Engine-based
small demo web browser.
But it never
works. It doesn't have a lot of features. And I've been waiting since then to actually be able to run it on Plasma Mobile. Yeah, we'd absolutely love to.
Plus, 1 year and a half, they didn't do this stuff.
Okay. No, another question. Okay.
Can we see a demonstration somewhere at this wonderful conference? Can I request
you
we have a demonstration on the Blue
System? I can either set up a Plasma Mobile demonstration at booths, or maybe you can come to Plasma Mobile BOF.
What's that you say? You're going to set up a demonstration on the Blue System stall. Excellent idea. I look forward to seeing it.
I can set up that.
Great.
Sure.
Okay, that's it, I guess. Thank you, Bhushan.
Yeah.
Thank you all.